Andres, what will the psychedelic enlightenment look like?
Yes, well, it's fascinating that we're currently undergoing the psychedelic renaissance, you know, the opening up of the possibility of actually studying these tools scientifically. But we clearly don't yet have, you know, an actual map. We have like alchemy, the alchemy of psychedelics. Like, you know, all of these different like therapeutic methods to kind of make them work better, but we don't really understand like exactly how they work and why they can be so beneficial. The image I brought in here is from the Hogan sisters, who happen to be conjoined twins that share part of the brain very deep, the thalamus. I think the psychedelic enlightenment would be something like that, in the sense of not only just giving a person a substance and, you know, from a third person point of view, see that they got better, but actually really deeply being able to image that person's experience, that the process they're undergoing, and actually what kind of a good qualia is being generated in the long term based on that. So it would be basically transforming kind of the alchemy of consciousness into the chemistry of consciousness, and psychedelics are a key piece of that puzzle.
And it's so important that psychedelics don't get corrupted by the similar forces that have previously been corrupting industries that have were supposed to be for the overall enlightenment of the planet.
Right, and I think that's gonna definitely be enabled by transparency about exactly what they're doing. So nobody can say, well, you can only do it if you follow my protocol. It's gonna be like a matter of science.
Excellent, yeah, the open sourcing, hopefully, and decentralization.